If you're building a comprehensive app in no-code software, it's a good chance you're using Sofdr as a front end. And one of the most important elements of this is how to create new records as they associate with all the other data in your base. For this, we have Sofdr Forms, but there's a lot to know about them. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking down all the nuance of Sofdr Forms. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you save up to 20 hours every week with no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about that, you can certainly start with understanding the fundamentals of automation. I've put together a free training webinar that's going to teach you how you can get started with no-code automation so that those repetitive tasks that you do day in and day out can be done in the background and you don't have to waste any more time on them. If that's of interest, check out that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include links below. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video. We're talking about Sofdr Forms. Now, if you haven't used it already, Sofdr is a front-end web app builder in the no-code space. So you might be storing your data in a database. My weapon of choice there is Airtable. And then you could build a layer on top that your users are interacting with. Your user interface where people are getting limited access to certain information and they have a customized web app experience. So Sofdr is the front end, Airtable is the back end. And in this particular case, we don't even need to use any automation third-party tools because Sofdr already has a simple integration already baked inside of the software. So first let's start with my Airtable database. Here I have three different key tables: projects, tasks, and users. My users table is where I'm going to store the information for people who will be accessing this web app. So most likely a name, and definitely need an email address. And some optional fields here are magic link and avatar. If you elect for this, a magic link will allow someone to sign in with a simple click of the link. And the avatar is where you can bring in who that person is and they can have a presence inside of your app. Two other fields in this particular table, I'm also bringing in the record ID. This is the user record ID. If you've never done this before inside of Airtable, every single record in the software at the time that it comes into creation has its own record ID assigned to it that is completely unique to that particular record. All we have to do in order to call upon that data is use a formula that says record underscore ID, open close parentheses, as you see here. So this is a best practice when working between Sofdr and Airtable to bring in record IDs into all of your tables just as a matter of habit. That way, when you need them inside of Sofdr, you can access them easily. And then the last piece here, I have a connection to tasks. And this is where any user is assigned specific tasks. And you can see here that this particular user, in this case me, has been assigned all these different tasks. Now let's go a little deeper and look at our projects here. A project is simply a name and then tasks assigned to that project. We've brought in a project logo. And again, back to my best practices here in working with Airtable and Sofdr, I've called the record ID for projects as well. Then lastly, we're going to take a look at our tasks table. And tasks, pretty straightforward, they link to both a project and a user. So we have two linked relationships here. We're linking tasks to projects and tasks to person assigned. Every task also has a name. And in this case, I chose this name strategically. I'm bringing in the project number first. So in this case, this is project one. So I've called this task 1-1, meaning that it's the first task for project one. 1-2 is project one, task number two, etc. This is going to be really helpful when we're looking in our Sofdr app to help us confirm that in fact we're looking at tasks that are assigned to a particular project and not other tasks. I also have a due date for my tasks, and as I mentioned earlier, bringing in that task record ID, in this case calling upon the record ID formula for every task, but you'll also notice that I've brought in the project record ID, and this is a lookup field. I'm looking at the relationship to the project, and I'm bringing in the project record ID. And so, of course, this project record ID is unique to the project that we've been assigned to. Now, this is going to come in handy when we want to filter the data that we are looking at inside of our Sofdr app. Similarly, over here, I also have the person avatar. And so this is where I'm able to say, look up the avatar in the users table which is connected through the person assigned field. All right, now that we have an idea of what our database looks like, it's fairly simple and straightforward. We now need to jump into softer so we can talk about how we can use a particular form in relation to creating a new task, automatically assigning that task to a project, and making sure that it's assigned to the person who created the task for themselves. Inside of Softr, you'll see I have three pages. The first one is my home page, which I've done nothing with. It's completely blank. I went right to projects and then to project detail. Projects is where we're gonna start from our app. And what we've used here is a list block, meaning we've listed out all the different projects in our database. Presumably, a user would then click on one of these projects to drill into it and get more clarity on the tasks for that specific project. In order to set this up, first we assign this block to the projects table and to the appropriate database. Then we come on down here and say, on click, we want to take the action of opening a page. What page? The project detail page. So let's flip into our project detail page. Inside of project detail, we have got a few different elements. The first block here is showing us information on that project. So here's the particular project we've clicked on, here's the name. Underneath that, we have a list of all the tasks that are a part of that particular project. And then at the very bottom, we have our form element. Now, if you've not used these features before, this first block here is simply a list detail block that's going into detail about the particular project that we clicked on from the previous page in our app. This next block here is a list block. And in order to make sure that we only see those tasks that are assigned to a particular project, we have a conditional filter here. This is not the point of the video, but I do want to stress that we're only going to see the particular tasks of the project that we've clicked on in this detail because of the fact that we said, look, I only want to see tasks based on these conditional settings. The project record ID, remember we looked that up into our tasks table, is the project's project record ID. So we're making sure that there's a match here. That project record ID that we've looked up on the tasks table must match the record ID of the project that we clicked on in order to get to this page. If it does not, we will not see that particular task. Drilling on down to the last part and the whole point of this though, we want to be able to automatically create a task for ourselves and assign it to the project that we are currently looking at and make sure that that shows up immediately. So how do we implement a form? There are a number of things that you can do with forms inside of Softr. In this particular case, I'll be showcasing the direct integration to Airtable, which has one simple action of creating an individual record inside of the table that you assign it to. In our case, we are creating a new task, so we will be assigning a name to the task, making sure to link it to the proper project, also giving this particular task a due date, and of course, assigning it to ourselves. Now, there are other advanced use cases where you might assign projects or tasks to other people, but in this particular one, we're going to be passing this information without actually inputting it directly in the form. It's going to be hidden on the back end, just as our linked relationship to project is. So how do we get all this working for us? So back into Softr, let's go step by step. First, we have the task name. Inside of every field or element that we add to our form, we're gonna have to make some determinations. What is the type of data that we're collecting here? In this case, the task name is just text. So we'll go with single line text. What is the label? That is how it's going to show up on the form. In this case, I want to ask for the task name. Do you want to bring in a placeholder? You can add some placeholder text inside of the field that will show up by default. In this case, I left this blank. And then lastly, and for our example, probably most importantly, we also have to make sure to tag it appropriately. Now, because we are going to be passing this data automatically back into Airtable, we need to make sure to match this tag identically with the field name in the Airtable database that we are creating the new record. Flipping back into Airtable, we have this field right here, which is the name of the task. Best practice is to simply copy that field name, fly back into Softr, and paste it here into the tag. Syntax matters here. If you don't get this exactly right, or if your field names change in the future, that will break this particular integration. Moving on to the next part of the field, we have a hidden field. This is the type here, and hidden fields are slightly more complex. What we're doing here is actually connecting to, if you look at the tag, this is the project field. So we want to write automatically what the project record ID is right there in the field, but we don't want to have to ask the person who's filling this out because we already know what project it is. Let's go back to the top of our app here. You see that we already clicked into a particular project. We know what project we're looking at. Because we're on a details page, we've drilled into a project, and we can pass that parameter along in a hidden variable or hidden field inside of our form. Now, if you have any questions, I strongly recommend checking out the Sofdr documentation. This documentation is going to go through all the different hidden fields that you can bring in to your Sofdr forms. You can use the logged in user's email, logged in user name, logged in user's record ID, logged in user's Airtable field, and then URL parameters and page URL. So there's a lot of information that we already know based on where we are inside of the steps within our web app in Sofdr, and we can pass that information along into our form and make it simpler for our users to interact with it. So in this particular case, we are using URL parameters. We are using the record ID of the project, and so I've grabbed this URL underscore param colon record ID. And that is the variable that we are plugging in here. So again, Sofdr knows automatically that this particular thing is going to be using the record ID of the project that we've selected up to this point. Now again, we have to map this to the right field in our Airtable base. So make sure to go back to your Airtable base, copy the field name, the column name, and paste it right back here. Now, we also have a due date in our third step here. Due date is, as you would assume, a date field. I'm labeling it due date, and it's going to be written to the due date field. So again, copy and paste from your Airtable field name back into Sofdr. Syntax matters here, so make sure you get that right. Lastly, we want to know who is this task assigned to, and this has to do with the logged in user parameter. So in this case, I'm using the logged in user record ID, and I'm plugging that in. Now, the part where this gets a little confusing, because we're using record IDs, is that when we look at our Airtable base, we think, this is a project, this is a person, why would I use a record ID? Well, in fact, these things right here, these are linked records to other tables, and each of them, if you recall, has its own unique ID, and so we don't have to necessarily map to the name of the project. The better plan is to map to the record ID because of the fact that the record ID is always unique. So let's flip back into Sofdr. We'll go ahead and publish our app, make sure that any changes we've made have now been saved, and I'm going to access this simple app now from my magic link. So I am now signed in as myself, and if I were to click on any one of these projects, let's say project 3, well, we're going to be taken to the detail page for project 3. That is confirmed right here because project 3 is showing up at the top. And if you notice in the URL at the very top of our screen, we are passing along the record ID of the project that we are looking at details on. And this, if you recall, is going to be the record ID that's passed in those URL parameters that we're using in our form. But I can go ahead and view the existing tasks for project 3. Remember our naming convention, we said project number dash task number. So I'm going to create a fourth task here for myself. It will be task 3-4, and it will be due on, let's say, the 30th. I'll create this task. At the time that it's created, we get this message that says the new task is created. Please refresh your page to view it. And this is important because that task will not show up here automatically unless we refresh the page. So going ahead and refreshing here, we now see task 3-4 with the appropriate due date, and you see that it's assigned to Gareth. Flipping back now into Airtable, we can see that in fact that particular task was created, properly assigned to this project, project 3, properly assigned to this user, the person who was logged in, and it has all of the other information provided, in this case the name of the task and the due date. Now, how do we map all this information to Airtable? It's actually really simple. Back in Sofdr, on the form block, on the right hand side, we scroll all the way down to what happens when the button is activated. In this case, we can change the text. I've done that to say create task. We also then say what action we want to occur. And you see that you've got a number of different actions, and some of this is much more advanced. We can send information to Make and trigger an automation, or to Zapier, or we can add things to MailChimp or MailerLite. But in this case, I want to keep it simple and just add a new record to Airtable. So I make that selection here, send to Airtable. I have to map it to the base, and I have to map it to the proper table. But you'll notice that that's it, Because of the fact that we've already properly assigned tags here, it knows exactly where to write that information. I don't have to map each of these fields independently. Because of the fact that we've already properly tagged them, it knows exactly where to send that information. It's that easy. I can then decide if I want to open a new page or to show a particular message. In this case, that's the message that I created. And flipping back now into my live app, if I were to back up and go look at other projects, I will not see those other tasks. Again, in my case, I created a new task for project 3, but here I've clicked on project 2, and I still just have the original 3 tasks for project 2. I can add a new one. Let's call this task 2-4, and it could be due whatever day, the 18th, create the task, we get the green checkbox, we refresh our page, and there we see the new task created right here that's only showing up in the project that the task is assigned to. I know we covered a lot in this video, and I hope it didn't overwhelm, but as I hope you can see, there is a lot of power here inside of the softer forms. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did and you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the channel so you can stay up to date with no code news, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.